The crown is a symbol of permanence.
It is not a choice. It is a duty.
But what about the life I put aside? The woman I put aside?
Across its six seasons, The Crown has inspired all sorts of reactions in fans, from celebration to criticism to controversy. But nevertheless, it will go down as one of the most lavish and celebrated TV productions of all time. And we'll never be royals.
It's the one in our blood. Imelda Staunton and Angela Bishop have flown all the way from Australia to be here today, so it's lovely to meet you.
Thank you, thank you.
And congratulations. You were playing Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II when we lost her.
Yeah.
How did that affect you, given where you were at with filming this series?
Well, it did affect us all. And weirdly, I had 10 days off in the schedule just after she died, which was the 10 days of mourning we had here. And I was pretty inconsolable, I have to say. But then, you know, you carry on, as she would have done. It was difficult for all of us. We had, you know, of course, we stopped filming for a while. But then, you know, we had to keep going.
Did you meet her?
I'd met her a few times, and I sang at her 90th birthday, I'm here to tell you.
What song?
Kylie.
The Queen Mother. What an incredible woman, and what an incredibly long life.
Yes, remarkable.
What was it about her that you grabbed onto playing her?
Oh, so much. But I think her strength and her wit.
It's very difficult. You know, it's funny to get the best job of your life when you're 80. I've waited an awful long time. It's difficult because somebody will say she's the best queen since Cleopatra. Somebody else will say she's a marshmallow on a welding machine. So it was quite difficult to play.
Were you a fan before you came on board? Were you watching it before you were in it?
I had been forced, interestingly not in the UK, but my Los Angeles friends had made me like, you've got to sit down and watch.
Really?
It.
The LA crowd?
Yeah.
What did they love about it?
They all love, they're all royalists.
Camilla had this massive jump in life while you were playing her. What was that like?
I think an actor always wants an arc. You know, you start in one place and you end somewhere very different.
You got an arc.
I got an arc. I mean, she was mucking out the stables of her Gloucestershire home, and then suddenly she's got the Koh-i-Noor on her head, you know.
Is it tricky to play someone when you know they might see it? They might react. Does that play in your mind, or are you able to put that to one side?
Yeah, I think I was. I was able, I mean, because especially him in this point in the show, I wasn't alive for most of that, if not very, very young.
Fair point.
Very, very young. So I didn't have any sort of connection to it. So I think I was able to separate the two.
There's something about looking back on this series as it wraps up after six seasons. It has made such an incredible impact. How do you, as someone who's been in it, sum it up?
I think it's been one of the great TV shows this country has exported.
It's wild.
It is.
It's wild. It's wild. It's wild. I mean, look at it. It's mental.
You learn so much history. That's what's amazing.
Hopefully it leaves us thoughtful about what it costs the individuals in this institution, what it costs them to do that job, because it's a job.
With all the varied reactions and debate around it, people watch this show, and I think, you know, we're all so proud to be in it.
The celebrations continue with a special screening of the final episode. Now, even we media types who get advanced copies of things haven't seen this one, and I'm told we're in for a surprise. And then I'm embargoed and can't tell you what's in it. But I'm about to go in and find out.
We're ready, ma'am.